Week 5 of the NFL season, and the Oilers have this Sunday off. Coming up on Quarterback Corner, we'll tell you why even at 1-3, there's no need to panic. The Oilers still can get back in the race.
Pro Bowlers Bruce Matthews and Mike Munchak have been a big part of the Oilers' offensive line for more than 10 years, but their friendship off the field has also been profitable. Later, we'll tell you why.
Punter Greg Montgomery and Bum Phillips start out your NFL Sunday with us.
From the KHOU studios, this is Gif Nielsen's Quarterback Corner with Warren Moon.
Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome again to Quarterback Corner. Not the way you guys wanted to enter the break, 1-3, and seemingly in turmoil. What's it going to take to turn this thing around?
Well, I don't think we have turmoil. I think the media is making more of the turmoil than anything else. I think our team just needs to start playing better football. That's our problem. We're not executing on either side of the ball the way we should be in order to win the games that we've been playing. And I think once we start executing the way we're capable of and playing with some enthusiasm and playing relaxed like we're used to, I think we'll start playing better. I think this break will be good for us to get back to doing that, getting back to the basics and also getting a chance to get away from the game for a few days.
There's so many talented athletes on this team, though, Warren. We look at it from the outside and we say it's in turmoil because nothing is coming together on the field, or so it appears.
Well, I've said many times before, it doesn't matter how much talent you have, you have to do more than show up. You can't just go out there and think showing up at the game you're going to win just because you have talent. We're realizing that, and we're finally realizing that we have to go out and play with emotion, we have to play with intensity, and we have to play for 60 minutes. And if we don't do those things, we're going to have the same type of season for a long time to come.
You know, it's kind of interesting. In football, it is just the little plays that really make things happen. And you guys were very close on a bunch of plays to make big plays in that game.
Things are getting better. You know, we were close on some big plays, and we also had a couple of big plays, but those ones that were just like a flick away right there in the back of the end zone. We had a guy wide open, but another receiver brought his man in there, and he should have never been in there. Those are things I think guys are trying to do a little bit too much on their own as opposed to staying within the system. And if everybody just kind of knows what their job is supposed to be and do that job and not try and do too much, we'll be okay.
One of the greater moments of last week's game, and there weren't a whole lot, the touchdown pass to Ernie Givens. That was a thing of beauty.
Well, it was a deep ball, and a lot of people have been criticizing us for not going deep, and the Rams were really kind of crowding our receivers, trying to take away the shorter passes. And what Ernest Givens gives us is a guy that stretches the defense with his speed, and he got behind the defense.
Now, wait a second. What is this?
That's his new dance there. And, he's got a repertoire. You know, the more he scores, the more you're going to see different things from him.
You know, it's kind of interesting because you threw an interception late in the game to Robert Bailey, and he returns it down the field. And this guy didn't just lay the ball down when he was tackled. He's basically saying, hey, Ernie, this is what I've got for you. Now watch this. He goes over and he's getting ready. Will he slide? He's looking for Givens. Oh, yeah, the electric slide. As a player, what do you do when you see those kind of things?
What can you do? I mean, they were winning at the time. They have a chance to rub it in like that. And if we're going to get up on those situations and be ahead in ball games, we'll be able to do those types of things. But I don't think that shows a lot of class, so I would never do anything like that to another player. I mean, it's humiliating enough just to be behind.
Now, you guys were in a situation where things were not going very well offensively, but you finally got that touchdown. And then the defense went out there and allowed the Rams to drive at the length of the field and score a touchdown. That had to be just humiliating.
Well, it was a big drive for us. We thought if we could have stopped them right there, the momentum was kind of taking over in our favor. The crowd was getting involved in the game. But the Rams, they showed a lot of patience on that drive, came back with some big third down plays, and were able to put another touchdown on the board and kind of silence the crowd and kind of take some of the steam out of our engine. So it was a big drive for them, and you got to give them a lot of credit for executing the way they did after us making the score 14-13 at that point.
What was the feeling on the sidelines? You're sitting over there and you're watching this drive be put together. What was the feeling over there?
Well, we're hoping just for somebody to make a play, somebody to make a big play, a fumble recovery, maybe a sack, maybe an interception, anything where we could get the ball back, because we felt like offensively we had just had that big play, that maybe that was a turning point that we could really get something going offensively.
One of the knocks about the Houston Oilers is it a team made up of individuals who care about themselves more than others? That assessment is certainly not fair, especially when it comes to this week's Oiler profile. brought to you by Leo Jarnigan Pontiac GMC. Matt Musil reports on perhaps the two closest members of the Oilers team.
Munchak and Matthews, longtime teammates and perennial Pro Bowl players. But theirs is not just a story of two teammates who play beside one another. No, this is a story of two young men who grew up on the job together and became as close off the field as they were on it. And the M&M boys have been hanging out together now for some 11 years.
Did you think back when you first met this guy that this kind of relationship would develop and then last as long?
Well, back then you don't give it a whole lot of thought. Back then so many guys were leaving and coming and going so much, so we weren't winning a whole lot of games. But I figured since he was a first round pick, there's a good chance he was going to stick around. So I figured he'd probably be the best guy to get to be good friends with.
I've been very fortunate and blessed to have his friendship. And as far as getting in business with him, I saw him invest in a couple things, and guys around town started calling him Midas, so I thought it would suit my interest best to get involved.
Since then, Munchak and Matthews decided to become part owners in Gold's Gym. The company now boasts of 9 franchises, 5 in Houston and 4 in Dallas. Thanks to a tip from one of Matthews' high school teammates a few years ago, he, Munchak, and teammate Doug Dawson started Snapple Beverage Distributorships in Houston and Dallas. And the latest venture that the M&M boys are involved in is the 2MQ Construction Company, specializing in custom homes and remodeling work. Matthews is the president. Munchak has been in the league 12 years now. Matthews has been around 11. And with Munchie's nagging knee problems this year, both players have been thinking more about their limited time left in the league and life after football. So even though this year's team is struggling, Munchak and Matthews know that their years together in the NFL are something that will be cherished for the rest of their lives.
We've both been very fortunate to have gone as far as we have, and when the football part is over, I think it's probably going to... It'll set us back a little bit, but we'll find something else to do, like arguing.
And speaking of construction, these two guys are the kind of guys who can help reconstruct what's happening this season.
Yeah, they're cornerstones in our offensive line. They've been together a long time, and they're leaders on our football team. And they're close friends off the field, and they're also in business together. People say we're not very close as a team. This shows you that we do have some guys that are close.
Still to come on Quarterback Corner, our weekly visit with former Oiler coach Bum Phillips. But next, punter Greg Montgomery.
Quarterback Corner is brought to you in part by Administav, your Houston area Jiffy Lube service centers, by Leo Jarnigan Pontiac GMC, and by Randall.
To make it in the National Football League, you have to demonstrate real effort, true ability, and genuine commitment. These are the qualities that inspired the standards for NFL Pro Line, the clothing and equipment worn by the players and coaches of the NFL. Maybe it's just the inspiration you need. NFL Pro Line, available at Foley's.
Hey, I got nothing against Randall's giving away free turkeys, but why do they have to make it so easy? You spend $30 or more each time you shop at Randall's or pick up specially marked products, and you get a turkey buck. Save Randall's turkey bucks, and you get a free turkey.
It's turkey buck time at Randall's. The more bucks you save, the bigger your free turkey. So start saving yours today.
All right.
Do you want your car done right?
If you want your car done right, it has to be done by the right people.
We take care of our customers. We do the job.
Is a CBS News special report.
From New York, John Roberts, and we are continuing to update you on the situation regarding the growing unrest in Moscow. President Clinton now entering the Rose Garden at the White House to make a statement about that.
A rather extended briefing on what we know about what is going on in Russia. and I want to make a couple of comments about it. First of all, it is clear that the violence was perpetrated by the Rutskoye Kashpilatov forces, that there has been significant violence today in Moscow. It is also clear that President Yeltsin bent over backwards to avoid the use of force, to avoid excessive force, as from the beginning of this. And I still am convinced that the United States must support President Yeltsin and the process of bringing about free and fair elections. We cannot afford to be in the position of wavering at this moment or backing off or giving any encouragement to people who clearly want to derail the election process and are not committed to reform in Russia. So we are following events moment by moment. As you know, we have access to television coverage there, so you are also pretty current on it. But that is the most I know now, and that is our position now.
Do you think that Yeltsin can survive, Mr. President, and will you cut off aid if he is deposed?
Well, I don't expect him to be deposed. I wouldn't overreact to this now. I think the people are clearly still far more supportive of him than Rutskoye or Kashpilatov, and they don't have any organized military support that we're aware of. So we'll just have to wait for events to unfold, but I have no reason to believe that he will be deposed.
Mr. President, have you spoken to President Yeltsin?
No. I'm sure he's got more important things to do right now than to talk to me, and I don't think the United States should be involved in the moment-to-moment management of this crisis, but I do want him to know of my continuing support and the support of the United States.
What can the U.S. government do right now?
Well, first of all, we can get as much intelligence as quickly as possible about what's going on, and we can do our best to look after the safety of the Americans who are there, and the security of the embassy, which has received some attention from our folks, and so far, the reports on that are good.
Have any plans to cancel your trip or postpone your trip in any way? No. What directions have you given our trip? No. Thank you. Have any Americans been hurt? No. The trip that you heard President Clinton talking about is a scheduled trip out to California today, in which he will be touting the health care plan in another town meeting. Mr. Clinton responding to the situation that has been occurring in Russia this past day. Just to get you up to speed on this, if perhaps you're getting a late start on this Sunday, it started a few hours ago, early this morning in the United States, as protesters who are loyal to Ruslan Kasbulatov, the parliamentary speaker of the Russian legislature, and Vice President Alexander Rutskoye, started battling with riot police who have ringed the Russian parliament, sometimes known as the Russian White House. They broke through police lines and made their way down the street to the Russian White House, where they encountered more riot troops. Those riot troops trying to quell the disturbance were forced to open fire with automatic weapons. It's not known at this point whether or not any of the demonstrators were either killed or injured, but we do have confirmation that a couple of Russian police officers were killed in the melee. Now, you heard President Clinton say that he believes at this point Kasbulatov and Rutskoye do not have any organized military support. In fact, it seems that there is little sign of popular support for the anti-Yeltsin demonstrators who have been running amok in Moscow. Jonathan Sanders joins us now live from our CBS News Bureau in Moscow. Jonathan, what's the latest there?
John, the latest is that the irregular troops loyal to the parliament stormed the mayor's office. They crashed a truck through there and then went running in with machine guns blazing, pulled out the police who'd been guarding that building, and then had their leader, General Makhachev, a former Soviet general who had run against Yeltsin and was trounced in the election a couple years ago, on the balcony saying, "This was our Russian Revolution. We're going to restore Soviet power." He then called on his followers to go out to the television station and try and seize it. We understand that there's very heightened security out at the television station. As I was driving back to the CBS Bureau from the mayor's office this evening, I ran into a column of armored personnel carriers, water cannon, and troops. I got out and spoke with the troops. They were mostly young boys from the Ministry of Internal Affairs. They said they were unarmed. They showed me their nightsticks and their shields, but said they had no guns. They also said that there are other troops being called up. Boris Yeltsin has declared a state of emergency in Moscow. The people are milling about outside the White House and outside the mayor's office. And a couple of them came up to us and said to our CBS camera, tell your President Clinton to get out of our business. Stop meddling in our affairs. We should decide the fate of Russia ourselves. There's a lot of anti-American, anti-Semitic feeling in the crowd surrounding the White House and the mayor's building today, John.
Jonathan, correct me if I'm wrong, but the riot police that have been stationed at the Russian legislature are from the Ministry of the Interior. What is the status with the Russian military at this point?
Well, the Russian military has said they backed Boris Yeltsin. John, I'll tell you, the thing that surprised me, I was in this whole march today, was the first line of troops that these some 10,000 demonstrators went through were all very young. I'd say boys 16 and 17, and they were extremely scared. Out around the White House, there were more seasoned troops, but they were quite scared, too, and they started opening fire with their Kalashnikovs, and they weren't just firing into the air. They were firing to scare people. As to casualties, I saw one person shot, and I believe that at least two people have died here, and the total's probably going to go higher. It looked like something out of a Wild West movie today, John.
Jonathan Sanders in Moscow, stay safe. We'll check back in with you as the events warrant. We just want to share with you a piece of videotape. Across the street from the Russian legislature is the Comic-Con building. It houses a lot of television news agencies, among them our CBS News Bureau. Acting on a demand from Alexander Rutskoy, the vice president, the man who was declared president after President Yeltsin dissolved parliament on September 21st, urged his supporters to stand up, take position, and attack the mayor's office. The mayor's office happens to be in the Comic-Con building. As we were setting up for a live broadcast a little bit earlier on this Sunday, a couple of those anti-Yeltsin supporters, armed with automatic weapons, came up to the 28th floor of the Comic-Con building, which is where our live position was, demanding that we take down that live position and vacate the building. Through negotiation between our correspondent, Cindy Kennard, our producers on the scene, we were allowed to stay in that position and brought you a live broadcast a little while ago. We will stay on top of the developing situation in Moscow. We will bring you further updates on this CBS News station. And stay tuned for the CBS Sunday Evening News with Paula Zahn and Harry Smith. Until then, John Roberts, CBS News, New York.
This has been a CBS News special report.
Quarterback, and do you think, with offensive line play and play calling by the coaches that you've had, would it have made a difference who the quarterback was and the losses you suffered?
You know, it's really hard to say who was a quarterback, what would have happened, but we have had some problems up front, and the coach, the calls as far as the plays have been pretty good. I just haven't played as well as I'm capable of, but I also know that I'm going to play well before this season is over, and hopefully it'll be very soon.
Against Buffalo, you'll need it up in up at Ridge Stadium. Your name, please.
My name is Michael Romano. My question for you, Warren, is are you feeling any anxiety about returning to Buffalo, especially since it's going to be on Monday night?
Well, I can't tell you I'm looking forward to going up there, but I think this is the type of game that we can use as a motivating factor to get us back on the right track. And going up there, we played well the last time in the first half. We just have to put two good halves together, and we'll be fine.
Your name, please.
Ronnie Richards.
And a question for Warren.
And Warren, my question is, on Sunday morning, what's your usual preparation as far as resting, studying, eating until game time for a home game?
Well, on a noon game, we don't have a lot of time. We get up at 7 o'clock and we have breakfast at 8 o'clock, which is our pregame meal, and we have to be at the stadium at 10. So it doesn't give us a lot of time to do anything in the morning, but maybe just get something to eat and get yourself packed up and get on over to the stadium. So it's a pretty quick morning.
Okay, those are questions from our studio audience. We're coming back with Bum Phillips when we return.
There's one thing that most sporting events have in common. When you see this R, the player's wearing a Russell Athletic NFL Pro-Line jersey.
Hi, Warren.
Hey, Joe.
Russell Athletic is also the official uniform supplier of Major League Baseball. They even have in most major college and high school teams. In fact, Russell Athletic even makes great sweats and tees for the rest of us. Unfortunately, not everybody's gotten the word.
Russell Athletic. It's everything we make that makes our sweats and tees so great.
Quarterback Corner is brought to you in part by NFL Pro Line, by Russell Athletic, and by Foot Action.
Dear Midas, as a woman, I often feel mechanics don't bother to talk to me.
You wouldn't understand.
But at Midas, I was treated with courtesy.
I'm Brett Foster. How can I help you?
And when I explained that I needed my car but did not have a lot of money, your inspection report was explained to me.
This shows you the repair options you can choose from.
Thanks for treating me as a person capable of understanding my car. Jane Robinson.
Leo Jarnigan's 93 model year closeout. Leo Jarnigan's liquidating every 93 Pontiac and GMC truck to make room for the 94. Over 100 Pontiacs with every Pontiac Grand Am, just $49 over invoice. Over 100 GMC trucks with every GMC pickup, just $49 over invoice. Plus, you keep any rebates. Katy Freeway, I-10 West, exit Derry Ashford, just 5 minutes west of Memorial City.
Jarnigan Pontiac GMC, we'll make a believer out of you.
Do you want your car done right?
If you want your car done right, it has to be done by the right people.
We take care of our customers. We do the job right.
At this Jiffy Lube, we use Pennzoil.
The customer comes first.
Can't do better than Pennzoil.
Experience counts.
We're only as good as our people. That's why Jiffy Lube is America's favorite oil change.
We got experience. Jiffy Lube.
Next time you pass a Jiffy Lube, pull in for Houston's number one oil change.
Coming back with my former head coach, Bum Phillips. And by the look of things, you want to be back as a head coach? What's the deal? How come all this publicity this week?
Well, I don't know. I really don't know, Gifford. That's kind of hard to figure. I walked away from a job of my own free will, wrote Boyd across a contract, a guaranteed 3-year contract, $450,000 a year, because I wanted to go do something else. Now, what makes anybody think I'm going to change my mind, I don't know.
Well, I think it's some members of the media. And you're part of the media right now.
No, I don't believe.
No, not that.
I'll always be a coach or ex-coach.
All right. You ready for this?
Yeah.
We got Bum's plays. Here they are.
Our belt of the week is actually hit below the belt. Colts quarterback Jack Trudeau gets knocked down late by Bill Johnson, but he doesn't take the shot lying down. I guess when Trudeau can't make a living throwing the football, he may want to try it as a place kicker.
Aww.
The bummer of the week goes to the fighting in college football. There were 4 major brawls in games last week. Perhaps the worst 2 episodes happened in the North Carolina-North Carolina State game and the Colorado-Miami contest. Seemed like Miami always in some kind of ugly incident each year. Let's keep the hitting clean. The bum steer of the week is from the Seahawks' John L. Williams. And this is how he handles a blitzing cornerback, driving Leonard Wheeler to the ground. I don't like the clinching fist, though. And the tip of the hat this week goes to the U.S. Ryder Cup team. While the football news continues to grab the headlines, not enough was really said about the golfers who beat the Europeans in England to keep the U.S. Ryder Cup at home where it belongs. Good going, guys.
Yeah, that's a little patriotic. Now, what are you going to do this off week? You're not going to do a game?
Oh, yeah. No, I'm going to go up to tomorrow morning. I'm driving to Oklahoma, and we're going to go up and see my mama, who's 94 years old and walks a mile every day, and I'm going to go up and walk a mile with her.
You mean you're going to be around that long?
Well, she's 94.
Well, if you follow along with your
mother. I'll be able to make it about the same finish line, about the same time. She crosses the finish line, I'll get there.
Okay, Bum Phillips, back with more right after this.
Do you want your car done right?
If you want your car done right, bring it to Jiffy Lube and ask for Pennzoil. This year, millions of people will rely on the quality of Pennzoil and the confidence of the Jiffy Lube pledge of customer satisfaction.
Everybody says they'll do the job right, but at Jiffy Lube, we guarantee it.
We got experience. Jiffy Lube.
Next time you pass a Jiffy Lube, pull in for Houston's number one oil change.
Are you spending so much time taking care of employee paperwork that you don't have time to take care of your business? Keeping up with all those quarterly tax reports, the W-2s, the W-4s, payroll, payroll tax deposits? Makes you feel like you have 900 employees instead of 19. Why not turn it all over to Administaff? Administaff, we take care of your people, so you could take care of your business.
Foot Action poses the question every man must ponder. Do you have what it takes to be an NFL quarterback? You need one great arm. Of course, if you just want to look like one, two bony arms will do. Apex Jackets and Hats, available at Foot Action.
Quarterback Corner is brought to you in part by Administaff, your Houston area Jiffy Lube service centers, by Leo Jarnikin Pontiac GMC, and by Randall's.
No game this weekend. What are the Administaff keys to the weekend?
Well, first of all, I think we need to have a good week of practice, which I think we've had. Now that the weekend is here, the guys just need to relax a little bit, get away from the game. Watch some other guys get beat up a little bit. Relax, like I said, get away from it all. Try and forget about what's happened over the last 4 weeks and just enjoy themselves. Come back next week with a fresh frame of mind, a new attitude, a fresh attitude, ready to beat Buffalo.
If there is one team that can turn this thing around and come back strong and still make an impact on the rest of the season, I think it's the Houston Oilers team. Do you agree?
I think we're talented enough to do it, and it's going to take some talent in order to get us back into the race. But you got to have a little bit more than talent. You've got to have that enthusiasm, and you've got to have that excitement that I was talking about earlier. The talent is there, and now we just have to get ourselves rejuvenated and get our motors going.
Do you think it will happen?
I really do. I'm positive it's going to happen. I think we've dug ourselves holes before, but we've kind of dug ourselves out and made a good season. I think we're going to make another great season out of this one.
All right. That's our show for this week. A reminder, we'll be back with the Jack Pardee Show at 10:30 this evening. We invite you to join us for that. Enjoy your Sunday of football.
Today's Quarterback Corner audience has been selected from registered Jiffy Lube customers. Go by your nearest Jiffy Lube, fill out an entry card, and mail it back. We could be calling you.